Well, it is a real pleasure to be here. My name is Daniel Rowe, and yes, my voice is going. So if at any point in the talk I become inaudible, you'll just have to imagine that I am telling you something pretty impressive. That's the sort of idea. So, let's see. If we can move on. So I am a member of the Nuxt core team, along with a number of other folk here. You've already heard from Lucy. Sebastian's going to speak in a moment, Alex as well. I'm also involved in a number of other projects like Magic Regex, Fontaine, which makes your layout shift disappear if you have custom web fonts, Elk, which is a client for Mastodon, and I have a website as well, so feel free to check out any of those that may interest you. This is my milieu. If you ever message me on Twitter or Discord or whatever, I'm probably sitting at this desk, and one of my three cats is probably stopping me from working. I don't know if you've ever experienced that you have changed your priorities for the day based on what your pet is doing. Because I 100% have. Like, there are times when I just cannot code because I actually have a cat here. So the only thing I can do is you know, read through GitHub issues or something like that. But sorry, I'm losing track. So I help build Nuxt, which is a framework for building web apps. And it's built on top of Vue, of course. Can I have a show of hands? Who here has used Nuxt? Okay, well, that will skip the next 10 slides. So recently, a couple of years ago, we had a significant opportunity to rethink what Nuxt was about, what we would do with it. Now, I mean, the core philosophy, the idea that you would be able to get started with best practice built in and customize as you went, is still there. But a lot of things were changing. So the move from Vue 2 to Vue 3, there was a breaking change in PostCSS, huge breaking changes in Webpack. At the same time, just as we were about, you know, to be all ready to go with Webpack, Evan, for goodness sake, releases Vite. What was that about? But I'm a big fan. But lots of opportunities to rethink. And alongside those, we had philosophical changes, like moving from a sort of a singleton approach where you sort of have everything defined centrally and available to you, to a composable approach where you can actually pull in features that you want and need, and actually only those get included in the bundle. An idea that you can actually share logic between components, lots of stuff that really made us think about what we wanted Nuxt to do. And I'm not going to talk about a lot of that, actually. I'm going to focus on the next piece, which we did, which was actually rethink the server. And how it was that we could write a server that would be designed for a serverless world, for a world of edge computing, for a world where you don't necessarily have a Docker container just always on or a server that's just constantly ready to return responses, but maybe you might need to fire something up. We moved, by the way, in Nuxt 2 from 300 milliseconds cold start to 5 in Nuxt 3. And we moved from 52 meg of bundle size to 3 in of server node modules in Nuxt 2 to Nuxt 3. So there are huge changes we made. But in particular, what I want to talk about today is I want to show off Nitro, which is the name we've given to our new server. We've released it so anyone can build on it. And I want to show you what it would look like to build Nuxt from scratch in a few minutes. I'm going to really very much try and do this, and I apologize as possible. I might go over to my Q&A. I'm going to build Nuxt from scratch on top of Nitro, powered by lots and lots of tools, which I'll show you as we go. So here we go. Let's dive in and build a framework powered by Nitro. So the first thing to do, this is an empty repository, basically. Nothing much there. I'm going to install Nitro. And H3, which is the server framework, a little bit like Express that we built on top of that, and start it. Okay, so off the top of our head, we have our web server that's running. Let's go to localhost 3000. Nothing there. Let's create a route. Foo. Nitro and Nuxt, we have a very much the idea that we want to be as minimal as possible and as intuitive as possible. So we can do something like this. And actually, if we hit that endpoint, I'll hit it actually just in this terminal here. It seems to be tiny. If I hit localhost, what was that? Foo. I get back JSON response. I've just returned an object. We also, as much as possible, try and auto-import things. And we do that in a pattern that we started with Nuxt. We provide our own TS config to let your editor know, your IDE know what's available, both in terms of, well, in terms of everything that we make available, whether that's type aliases, buffer paths, or making your editor know about what is auto-importable and what isn't. We can also do really cool things like this. Say I, let's see, duplicate this as another handler. I can actually get type safety on fetches across my app. So it knows the routes that exist. It knows the return types for that data. And so I could do something like this and actually get full type safety. It's quite fun. And what you also notice, might not, is that this $fetch thing, when used in a server context, actually doesn't hit the network layer. It just makes a function call. So it's as much as possible, we're trying to make it as performant as we can. In Nuxt, as it happens, when you run that fetch call, it will make a request to the server, so it works isomorphically. Okay, so we've got a server up and running. That's just sort of hot reloading in the background as we make changes. I've deployed websites that are purely server-focused and using just Nitro, and it works nicely. But let's do something Vue-related. So let's add a handler that's going to handle all non-server routes. So we have some server routes like bar and foo, but maybe we also want to sort of render a Vue app, some HTML. And so we might do something like this. We're going to render some HTML. And if we hit that some other page, you'll see HTML comes back. But that would be really time consuming if I just typed everything out. Let's do this with Vue. So let's install Vue. A Vue plugin for it. Let's create a Vue app. So this will just say, let's see, I'll actually import something to make it a little bit more beautiful. And just say, hi, Vue.js London. Okay. Really what we want to be able to do is import that and render it to string and return it. So we'll do that. So we'll get create app from Vue. We need to be able to render it to a string, so we'll do render to string. And we also need to import the app itself. And basically, what we want to be able to do is create the app. We want to be able to render it to string. Ah, yes, Copilot. When it hits, like when it's working well, right, it's really good. Okay, and then we want to return that. So we basically want to return it here. And then we've got a bit of HTML going on. That's not going to work because Nitro won't understand Vue. So we need to add some configuration. And we can do that like this. TypeScript can help us here. We want rollup config, and we're going to pass a plugin. And I'm cheating. This is not really what you should probably do, but I'm going to use a Vite plugin. Just pass it in like that. Let's try that. Yay, it's working. We've got some HTML coming back. How about that? Woo. You're all like, hey, come on, Daniel. We do this all the time. Okay, so we probably need a template to put that in. So we'll say, hey, London. And we'll grab that text here, just a basic thing. Put that in as our, there we go. So we have a template now. And really, we want to render more than just the Vue app is going to render back, because all it's going to render is the component. We want a whole web page. So we're going to use a feature of Nitro called the storage layer. Now, the Nitro storage layer is a KV store that is vendor agnostic. So it works with Redis, with memory, it works with Vercel KV, it works with like databases on the edge like PlanetScale, Cloudflare KV storage, lots of other things, but it also works with the file system. So we're going to pull in this index.html file from here, use storage, and we're going to get root index.html. And that we can just return template replace. And what did I put in there? This. Okay, so that should render me a whole page. Great. So it doesn't look any different, right? It's still the same thing. But it's actually running a full HTML site, which is great. Now, what we would really like to do is have this not just be server rendered. We want it to work on the client side too, so you can have interactivity, so things can actually work well for you there too. So let's do that. We're going to need to add Vite. There we go. So we're going to need to change the Nitro config a little bit here. We're going to use something called a dev handler. And that is, we're going to basically need to initialize Vite to run on the server as well. So we're going to give it a path, which will be __Vite, so we know it's meant for Vite and not anything else. And we're going to give it a handler. We're going to use something called a lazy event handler, which means that the first time it's hit, it will initialize, but it won't initialize before that. There are a lot of really useful helpers like this added by Nitro throughout your app. So if you're using Vue, Nuxt, you can do the same. And you're telling me I've been talking for 15 minutes. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Okay, so we're going to create a dev server here. We'll create it. We'll make it a custom app type. We need to import this. We'll make it a custom app type. And it will need to have a middleware mode. And I think we'll need to pass a base as well. Great. And we'll use another utility here from H3 to get our middlewares. Okay, seems about right. Let's see, is that going to work? We are going to should be able to hit Vite client. Okay, and it's returning us something. So, thank you. So I think we should be able to add a script here. And give it Vite client. And I think that should load us up a Vite server. Connected. Excellent. So we have Vite working. But what we don't have is any kind of hot reload or anything. It's not really connected. All it's doing is the server's there. So let's move this out into a different place. Let's move this into, we'll call it app, and call this the server endpoint. We need a client one too, which will handle whatever's going to happen on the client side. We're going to use create SSR app, which will hydrate a view rendered on the server side. And we'll do the same thing. We'll create the app, but then we'll just mount it. Like this. What's going on there? Right. Okay, seems good. And we'll have to add the same to our script. So now we have this. Okay. No. Not working. Let's try that again. Oh, why isn't it working? Because I moved it into some other folder. Let's configure that. So we'll need to tell Nitro that this exists. So we have this new handler called, we want it to capture everything. And the handler is going to be in app client or server on the Nitro side. It's saving as I type, so it dies. Oh, error. That's fine, actually. We just need to tell Vite that it should process Vue as well. For goodness sake. Okay, there we go. Let's see. Is it really working, or does it just look like it is? Ugh. We do, it seems. Amazing. So, there you go. We've built Nuxt in a few minutes. And tragically, I don't have time to show you any of I'll show you a few things. Show you a few things. But I'm aware we probably do need to wrap up. Basically, we have Vite set up, and the whole thing is powered by Nitro under the hood. If you're wanting to explore Nitro, it is possible to build a framework on top of it. So analog.js, which is a framework for Angular, is built on top of Nitro as well. Obviously, Nuxt is too, and we would really welcome other frameworks to do the same kind of things. It provides all the primitives that you might need. So we have authentication, for example. You can use session to create a persistent session stored across requests via cookies. I mentioned, obviously, storage, the KV, support. It has support for deploying to any serverless or non-serverless target you might think of, from Docker to Vercel to Netlify with zero config to Cloudflare to Lagon, a new runtime. And you can define root rules individually per endpoint. So you can specify certain ones to be ISR, certain ones to be server-side rendered, and some not to be. Whatever you can think of, it's possible to do. Please do follow up. Do contact me if you'd like. I'll push up this code and maybe a little bit more if I have time to Daniel Rowe, Vue.js Live, so you can take a look at what it might look like to build a serverless framework on Nitro. And if you do want to try out Nuxt, which I would very much hope you do, and try out Nitro in a full production framework environment, check out nuxt.com. And the docs for Nitro are on nitro.unjs.org. And do follow the Nuxt Twitter account. And we have a release, a minor release of 3.5 with some amazing features, including typed root rules, which Eduardo demoed earlier today, coming out today or tomorrow. That should be pretty fun to see. But that's all for now. And please ask me questions in a moment. It's been a real pleasure and a delight to be here in London. Thank you so much.